Well, good morning. It is Friday, and yet we are heading towards the weekend, and we have been speaking about you can this entire week. And yes, you can. Philippians 4:13 says we can do all things through Christ, who is our strength, who has become our strength. So today I want to say to you, you can. The gospel is good news. I know it's good news. You know why? Because when I first heard the gospel, I accepted the good news of what Jesus Christ did for me. The first time in my life I ever heard of the story of Jesus and what he did on the cross of Calvary, my hand went up like a flash. Let me tell you, I accepted him into my life and I've never left that behind. I always continued to put my faith and my trust in the good news that I heard some 45 years ago. And you know what? It's still good news today. Listen to what the psalmist writes in Psalm chapter 1, 1 through to 3. It says, "Oh, the joys of those who do not follow the advice of the wicked, or stand around with sinners, or join in with mockers. But they delight in the law of the Lord, meditating on it day and night. They are like trees planted along the riverbank, bearing fruit each season." You see, if we put our faith and our trust in God, God again says that I'll never leave you nor forsake you, that I'm there to build into you, to produce the fruit that needs to be produced in your life, that will help others, that will touch others, that will encourage others. You know what? If you're a Christian, then you need to be an encouragement for those around about you. And how do I encourage people around about me? With good news. Yeah, not just listening to bad news, not just listening to the news that we hear each day that we read about, but putting our faith and our trust in the good news that Jesus Christ is seated upon his throne and the enemy cannot dethrone him. In actual fact, he is there with us always, leading us, guiding us, helping us, comforting us. This is why he has given to us Holy Spirit. You see, if you caught up in those who are constantly preaching a fear message of doom and gloom, you are going to shrivel up and spiritually you're going to die. You know why? Because you are never going to obtain victory. You cannot obtain victory when there's constant fear being pushed on you. And again, you constantly living in fear. Fear will never develop a person to become the person that God desires them to be. But the enemy wants to trip you up. Not so. By again reminding you of the fear, by looking to the things that are collapsing around us and by putting our focus upon that, we will never enter into the promises that God has for us. So for God to rewrite your story in 2021, you have got to change your channel of influence. You have to get back to the Word of God. You have to begin to listen to the messages of good news, of the good news of the finished work, of the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. You see, Jesus Christ is not returning for a church that is defeated and broken. He is coming back for a church that is radiant and alive, who is in control of their lives. You know, I've officiated many weddings, and it always surprises me on the rehearsal night when the bride comes down and we do the rehearsal and we go through things, and she looks just plain and yes, always pretty and good looking, but amazingly, on the day of the wedding, and when the groom is standing there alongside of me and we're waiting for the bride to come down the aisle, and all of a sudden she appears at the front door, and my goodness, what a change. Kind of like, is that the girl that was at the rehearsal? Is this really the bride of the groom to be? And she's totally changed, radiant, beautiful. You know what? As I've said, I've officiated many, many weddings. Never have I seen an ugly bride. They were always beautifully made up, ready for their new adventure with their groom. Now, this is what Jesus is coming back for. And I want you to hear this. Jesus says he's coming back for his bride. Now, I don't believe he's coming back for a bride that is broken, beaten, bruised, and ugly in the makeup of what and what the world has pressed upon us. No, no, no. The bride overcomes that. She is radiant. She is beautiful. She is made up to be something that when the groom sees her, his jaw drops, just like Adam did when he saw Eve for the first time. And he said, "Whoa, man, is she for me?" You see, that is the heart sink that we have. And I believe this is whom Jesus Christ is coming back for. A bride that has everything in place. You hear what I'm saying to you? And again, people are saying, man, you know, everything is falling apart. Everything is being destroyed around us. Everything is collapsing around us. No, 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 no. I believe that Jesus Christ is coming back for a bride. And again, we need to rewrite this into our lives. As a church, we are planted at a riverbank that never runs dry, that constantly gives life to the trees planted at the riverbank, producing fruit. This is what we're doing. You see, again, we are producing fruit. We are a tree planted at the riverside. And if you look at a tree that is planted at a riverside, man, it's beautiful to see the fruit that hangs from it for all to partake from it. Open your eyes. This is what we need to do. Look at the condition of your life. Is it ready to meet your Savior? That is what we need to ask ourselves. And come on, if you're that bride that is not looking like the bride that should be, then I want you to begin to change your life. You need to change some things, guys. Listen, we need to get things right in our lives because Jesus is coming back for a perfect bride, a beautiful bride, a radiant bride, a bride that is ready to meet Him. So your story needs to be His story of what Jesus Christ has done in your life by bringing you out of darkness into the glorious light that He has given to you and I. You see, Israel lost themselves in a wilderness because they would not change their story to His story. Jesus Christ is good news. What story are you telling? Again, just listen to your stories. When you speak to others around you, what does your story sound like? Does it bring good news or is it filled with bad news? Well, if it's filled with bad news, then come on, today it needs to change. Ask Jesus to become Lord and Savior of your life because He's coming back for a bride that is radiant and ready to meet Him. Are you?